Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. I appreciate each and every one of you that have subscribed to my channel. Interesting earthquake there in the South Bismarck Sea. A magnitude 6.5. USGS said it was near Papua New Guinea. Three people said they felt it. It was deep. 598.9 kilometers in depth. It was about 372 miles below sea level. They used to believe that very deep earthquakes such as this just didn't happen, and new research is trying to say that it's caused by the subduction of the land carrying water down to the depths. Being so deep, you got the pressure of the depth and you got the temperature. This area of the mantle is supposed to be very fluid, where earthquakes are not supposed to happen. Going to Google Earth here, we have the South Bismarck Plate. It's slowly doing a clockwise rotation. And down over here is that earthquake. Close to New Britain. And over here we got the New Britain Trench. But this was actually caused by a very old ancient slab of the Pacific Plate. And over here to the east, we got the Pacific Plate that is moving towards the west. Yeah, I don't think this earthquake was caused by water exploding down there in the mantle of the earth. To the south of the New Britain Trench, we got the Solomon Sea Plate. Here's a paper I found talking about the Solomon Sea Plate and the different sea mounds. It says here, this leads us to our model of a subduction zone of the northern boundaries. Well, the northern boundary would be the Bismarck Plate. Furthermore, there is a discrete zone of earthquakes which appear to indicate a structure that hinders the descent of the slab on the northeastern boundary of the Solomon Sea Plate. That structure may be a slab fragment from the Pacific Plate. And they have an image here showing the depth of different earthquakes they've had in the past. It looks like close to 600 kilometers. So that would be about 370 miles. A clearly delineated subduction of the Solomon Sea Plate under the South Bismarck Plate. The BSSL and the North Bismarck Plate, a reversal of polarity in the deepest parts of the subduction zone, indicate the possible influence of an earlier subduction zone. A possible slab tear at the leading edge of the Solomon Sea Plate may also allow the Pacific Light MORBS of the Solomon Sea Plate mantle to reach the SER. I tracked down that tear that they're probably talking about, and that is this area right here. I have a 3D images of it. All right, here's north at the top. You notice this small landmass here, and this is the subduction zone for the New Britain Trench. And let me bring it down. There's the tear. Now we're looking north towards the right here. And then north looking towards the left. You can see here that this slab tearing probably goes down to about 400 to 500 kilometers. So that would be between 210 and 350 miles below sea level. I also found that they believe that these deep earthquakes, there generally is not an aftershock or another earthquake caused by these earthquakes. Some may say there could be a earthquake of a large magnitude coming later along the New Britain Trench, or up over here along, let's see, the North Bismarck Plate. the Menace Trench. So here's the location of the 6.5. We have an area of spreading right through here. And spreading is caused by magma coming up. And then off over here to the top right, I would say if there's going to be an earthquake, it would probably be up in this location. But in the past, that has not caused it. Now, the opposite area of the world, if you're looking for, you know, earthquakes that may occur on the opposite side, that would be on the eastern side of South America, which would be over here. And there's been a few earthquakes along this one fault zone. Let me zoom in here. Yeah, we've had like 5.6, 5.2, a 6.5. This is the Mid-Atlantic spreading ridge that goes down through here. Yeah, like I said, there's just too much pressure down there. It's just too fluid for water to be causing explosions for these deep earthquakes. What are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Please thumbs up my videos. Thank you for subscribing. And as always, please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.